Hello, and welcome to another Nth Dimensional production. Today, we're tackling the standard sleeper cache. This is an exploration site, a level 4 data site. It is a special kind of site, the sleeper series. And then this is the standard one, and that is going to be the mid-tier one. Limited is lower, and superior is higher. So this is going to be, in my opinion, the most complex sleeper cache. But we should be able to handle it just fine. Our fit for today is going to be a pacifier, but you can actually handle this site in pretty much any ship. I've even done it in a exploration frigate, or rather a expedition frigate, so the Endurance. That said, you need one of two things to make this pretty possible. The first being a cloak or an afterburner. In this case, we're going to go with the cloak option, and then this is going to come in handy the way that I run the site. There are obviously multiple different ways to run these sleeper caches, but I find that this one is the most consistent, quickest, and all around kind of just best option. So we went ahead and scanned down the site, and if you notice here, you see a rift as well as the hyperflex generator. This is just showcasing that sometimes these sites get buggy. I mean, they have lots of features included into them. But normally, you would have to hack this hyperflex generator, and that would make the strange rift appear. But in our case, the rift is already here, so we're going to go ahead and go in. And step one is to see how the site looks. When you have a strange rift already there, the site could be in a different kind of state. The worst is probably when there's a big green cloud everywhere. In that case, the site's pretty much done, but you can sort of salvage the last room. But here it looks like everything is where it should be. We got a bunch of, you know, cans and whatnot over here. We have this middle area with one turret and a can, and then we have this back area with a few different remote defense grid, a storage depot, and three turrets over there. So step one, whenever you're doing a sleeper cache, is go ahead and bookmark the site as soon as you go into there. And then how we're going to be handling this site is, first we're going to take care of this first room. And you can actually do this later as well if you're feeling a little less confident, because there are some triggers in here that will end the whole site in this first room, but we'll get to those. So we're going to do the first room first. Then we're going to take this rift. It says that it's already calibrated, but there's also an uncalibrated. So here is a little bit of weirdness. There's supposed to just be an uncalibrated lift here, but it looks like there's actually two rifts there. But we're going to hopefully figure that out, and that's going to be fine. Again, features in these sites. So we're going to do this first room, and then we're going to teleport with this rift over to this back room. We're going to handle this back room, and we're going to do it a little bit of a special way, and then we're going to trigger some noxious clouds, which will make another rift spawn. We'll go into that third room in this middle area, and then we'll do that third room there. So let's begin. Like all the other sleeper caches, they do give you a freebie can kind of at the start. And that's going to be this one, so you just go up to it and you hack it. And something to note in the background is that there is an alarm system in these sites. And so whenever you fail a hack, depending on what can it is, there is a chance that an alarm goes up. And let's actually bring up our local again, because we do need to be looking at it a little bit. So local chat, you guys can see this. Right now there's nothing interesting, but some interesting text will come up later. And what you need to kind of just worry about is if red text appears in your local that says the alarm has been triggered, level 5, you have 30 seconds to get about 60 kilometers away from everything before gas clouds come and explode your ship. And then after that, about 30 seconds more, larger gas clouds will come, in which case you need to be like 100K away. All right, so this second can is a little bit special. And for reference, it's the furthest away one in this first room. And it's always this can. When you finish this hack, a alarm clock will drop, and you have to hack that quickly, or else the alarm will go all the way up to 5 and the gas clouds will come. We want to avoid that at this point, so as soon as we finish this hack, we're going to work quickly to hack the dropped alarm clock. We do that. Go ahead and give it a loop. It says defense alarm unit. It spawns right next to it. We just lock it up, and we start to hack it. You have, I think it's a minute. It said on that little last prompt. I believe it's a minute to hack this. So you'll want to kind of work quickly. We got that no problem. And when you successfully hack it, a pristine storage depot will come out. So we're going to go ahead and head to that and hack this pristine storage depot. Okie dokie. And then we head on to the last can in this first area, which is just up here. So a newt did enter my system, and we are in NullSec. So I'm going to go ahead and bring up the directional scanner, just to make sure. Okay, it looks like he's in a capsule. No worries there. If he wasn't in an exploration ship and he did come into the site, there are ways to kind of trigger the site to kill interlopers. But in this case, looks like we're just going to let him pass on by. All right, so we've hacked all of the goodies cans, the depots, in this first area. And now we're ready to move on to the second area. And the way we do that is we go to these three coordinate plotting devices. It's very important in the way that we do the site. And if you read on like Eve Uni Wiki or whatnot, they'll probably talk about this remote defense grid unit and hacking it in the first room. But the way we do the site, we don't hack this remote defense grid unit yet. We save it for a special purpose later down the line. But what we are going to do is hack these three orbs, and they're going to give us coordinates. And you don't actually have to loot these coordinates. They will auto drop into your cargo hold. So just a couple of easy peasy hacks here. I say easy peasy, but I believe they're all red hacks. There's one. And to note, all of the lootable items or cans are going to be relic hacks. And all of the kind of site interesting mechanical hacks are going to be data hacks. So we use a integrated analyzer, which is both a relic and data analyzer, to do ours. And we match it with the black glass implant. All right. So we got these three coordinates over here, X, Y, and Z. And we're going to go over to this right calibration device, the high power calibration device. And we're going to deposit. So just open the cargo here, and we're going to deposit, come on, click. We're going to deposit our three coordinates. And what this does is turns this supposedly uncalibrated rift into a calibrated rift. So now it says calibrated long rift, and that's what we want. We're going to go ahead and approach it. And these rifts are a little bit weird, so just kind of double click past it. And then once you're close enough, you can click on it and hit warp. So the next thing we're going to do, this is the important and deadly part, so pay attention. When we warp over to this other side, we're going to warp to this beacon, or at least near this beacon. If you have an afterburner, you just start orbiting this remote defense grid, probably like 1,000 meters or so, whatever you kind of have as your orbit. You start orbiting this remote defense grid unit and put on your afterburner as quick as possible. If you're feeling it, you can overheat it as well. We want to keep our SIG down and our traversal high. The reason for that is because these three turrets are going to start shooting at us. And they do a lot of damage, especially if you're standing still. It is very possible to get one shot in your frigate by these three turrets. So we use the afterburner to get traversal very quickly after we land over here, so we mitigate the damage that way. Alternatively, we can use a cloaking device, and this is a little bit more risky. You turn on your cloaking device as you're warping to this back area, and then you start to orbit this remote defense grid. And then you'll get some traversal, you'll get some speed gained through your stealth. And then when you come out of stealth, you should hopefully be going quick enough slash have a small enough signature radius that these turrets aren't going to obliterate you. Do not use a microwarp drive here, because that will increase your signature radius way too high, and you will get blapped by these turrets. So, after we are orbiting this remote defense grid unit, we are going to hack it, and on successful hack, it will disable one of these turrets. I believe it's this close turret. After that, we're going to warp out of the site. When we are out of the site, we have 2 minutes before we need to get back into the site, or else it will despawn. Again, make sure you've bookmarked your site. It is very important, because that will be the only way you can get back to the site. You can bring up your bookmark list with the L key, and this spot in the solar system is our bookmark for this site. So I'm just going to go through it. You'll see how it plays, and hopefully we don't get exploded. So you do land, I think it's about like 2.5k away from this beacon, or some, it's in some kind of range. Sometimes you don't get cloaked. It's just very important that as soon as you land, you are cloaked when you land, and you start orbiting this remote defense grid unit as soon as possible. It's very important. All right. So we click on the calibrated rift. We hit the activate gate.
Warp drive.
We close the little dialog box. During our warp, we hit our cloak, and then we just start to hold down W and start orbiting this remote defense grid. Looks like we landed a good way off of the beacon. So we're getting up this traversal. We're at about 450 now. And then we're going to become uncloaked. And once we do that, we go ahead and lock up this remote defense grid unit. You'll auto uncloak once you're closer than 2,000 kilometers or meters away from this defense grid unit. As you can see, all three of the turrets missed me. And that is just by, I have no afterburner on, no prop mod on. I just have a small signature radius and high traversal. So we hacked that. We did get hit that time pretty heavily, about 80% of our shields, but we hacked that and then we warp off of the site. And here's where the magic features come to help us. So for some reason, when you do this and you warp off the site and you warp back onto it, the back two turrets most of the time like to just shoot random stuff and not you. So assuming things go correctly, like they pretty much always do, we will no longer be taking any damage from those back turrets. In the event that they still do want to target us, we can just go towards them, warp off the site, warp back on, and just rinse and repeat until we are successful. But it basically always happens. And the way we can check is, once we're on the site, we just go ahead and look over at this beacon, and we're looking for some lasers coming out of these turrets. All right, so you can see that they're shooting the remote defense grid, and that means we are safe. We did it. Good job. So we just go ahead and fly over to this calibrated long rift. There are some more newts in system. Make sure you always keep an eye on your local if you're doing this in hostile space. And if need be, hit your D scan.
Warp drive Active.
Make sure you stay safe. But there's an Ashimu. We're not worried about an Ashimu coming into this site. Furthermore, once you hack the first lootable can, the site will actually go away from the probe scanner window. So the only way to get to us now is through combat scan probes. And now we just go ahead and start hacking these containers. Okie dokie. And the secret to the back room is that you can see on the kind of field, there are these impenetrable storage depots. They don't look like hackable cans yet, but in fact they are hackable cans. You just have to get close enough to them to kind of figure out what they are. So right now it's just an impenetrable storage depot, but once we fly closer to it, it will turn into a depot that we can actually hack. Looks like there are actually combat probes out. So we are going to have some visitors. But we're going to try and play this interestingly. We're going to welcome them into our site. I'm not sure that they would actually even want to come in. We'll see what they do. I have a feeling that the core is also over here. Yep. Okay. So, in the event that they come, we need to trigger the alarm. Best way to do it from over here, you can damage these sleeper enclaves and that will trigger the alarm, but we need a gun to do that. Right now we don't have any gun. There's also Hakate. They're actually probably the ones with the probes. We'll just see what they do. Oh, there's a box down here that I didn't look at. I have a feeling that they're not crazy enough to enter the site with me on it. Generally, people aren't, because it is very kind of a dangerous area for all parties involved. But I'm just watching, seeing what they might do. And we got one more can. We're going to go ahead and put our AU descan down to one AU. So the Hakate is likely on the outside gate of this site. And we'll bump it back up just to see if we get any other visitors. Right now it's also just the Ashimu. There's the core. All right. And so normally what you would do in this area is maybe we can try and bait the Hakate. Normally you would warp out and warp back in, because now we want to get to this first area remote defense grid unit. Our other option would be to just fly there ourselves. We just go up and around. That's probably the safer option. I think that's what we're going to do. We're actually going to try something. We're going to target a sleeper on K-Lave and see if neutralizers work on it. Nope, neutralizers don't. Also, drones don't work on it, so you need like an actual gun to shoot the Enclave if you want to trigger the alarm from over here. I think we're going to take the safe approach, and we are just going to fly. So now we're going up and around. You want to stay, I think it's 60 kilometers away from this sentry tower. Otherwise, it will start shooting at you. Oh, here he is. Here both of them are. Let's see what they might do. We could go to this remote defense grid and trigger it. I think that's the play. We'll play it a little risky. We're going to get in range of this sentry tower. And we want to pulse our microwarp drive. So basically it takes... It looks like maybe it was shooting at something already. Oh, it's shooting at the Hecate. Okay. We're going to start flying out this way. And I think we got a warp. All right.
Warp drive active.
So we're going to warp off this way. But I think we might come back. That's a little dangerous, actually.
Warp drive active.
Again, we have 2 minutes. So let's see if we activate this gate and then we cloak.
Warp drive active.
Going in. Let's see where we land. We're going to land too close to this beacon. Oh, but close enough here. Okay. So now we're going to, since they're off the site, we're going to trigger this remote defense beacon. All right. So because we failed that, which is what we wanted to do, you can see the text in red says that the alarm has gone off and that in 30 seconds gas clouds will come. Like the Hecate is still haranguing us. And I think we'll take a nice little cloak here. Gas clouds might get them. Come on, gas clouds. They're about to expand. And hopefully he is in. Ha ha! He looks like he's pretty heavily in those gas clouds. Let's hope he explodes. Looks like he possibly made it out, but hopefully the turret will finish the job for us. He warped out. Okay. So now because we triggered these gas clouds by making the alarm go off by failing that remote defense grid hack, and you might have to fail it multiple times, up to like 5 times. But the gas clouds come, they expand after like a 30 second, or they come after 30 seconds and then expand after another 30. And then a spatial rift comes. And we want to get into that spatial rift. So we're getting into the range of this sentry tower, which is going to be 60 kilometers. And then after it hits us, we're going to put on our micro warp drive. We're going to pulse it, so just make it go once. And it should be finished, so we shouldn't have any more SIG radius increase before the turret shoots again. And by then, we should be close enough to the rift to actually use it. Getting closer. We're going to go ahead and head this way to get a higher transversal. Looks like our neutrals left the system, so we're feeling pretty good. All right, so there it shot at us. It missed us because our traversal was nice and high. We go ahead and pulse our micro warp drive, just use it once, get closer to this rift. All right, so that cycle is finished, so our signature radius is down again, and then the turret will shoot us again. It misses again. We go ahead and use our micro warp drive on. And then we activate the rift.
It says empty. Active.
And this brings us to the secret room. And the secret room is kind of like a time trial. So once you get in here, there's going to be this beacon. You just kind of orbit around the beacon. You just move around a little bit. And then this remote defense grid unit will appear. You go close to the remote defense grid unit. And you start hacking it. On successful hack of this, 4 new cans of loot will appear. And you have 3 minutes to hack all of these cans before they disappear. It says something like explode, but it does no damage if you fail, or if you wait the timeout, they just go away. So now we have 3 minutes to hack these 4 cans. If you need more time, there is another can that spawns, and it is going to reset your timer up to 3 minutes, so it puts it back at 3 minutes. And that spawns near where you started. Looks like we don't have enough cargo space. We're going to go ahead and get rid of these kind of meta modules that drop. They're heavy and not super worthwhile. The self-destruct sequence unit is the thing that you need to hack if you want more time. We're feeling decently confident in our hacking abilities, so we're going to go for all 4 cans before that time is up. If you want to learn about how to become an excellent hacker, there is a YouTube video about that. Just go ahead and check out the channel, and I'll probably link that video in the description as well. And kind of a final note, the things that you find in these sleeper caches are this blue loot, which you sell directly to NPCs, so that money is always going to be that amount that's listed. blueprint copies for exciting storyline modules, and kind of some meta modules, which aren't great. They're mostly just junk. But yeah, you can expect to probably get about 75 million to 100 million of blue loot in these sites on top of a few blueprints. And the blueprints can vary pretty drastically in their worth. For instance, you could get a one run of a polarized small focus blueprint, which is going to net you about 1 to 2 million. Or you could get one of these 50 MN digital boosters, 3-run copy, which is going to net you around 1 to 150 million-esque. Yeah. So, all in all, not bad. Definitely worth running. The big money is going to be in finding these good blueprints, but you also do get some pretty good money through these blue loots. In fact, the highest single can that has been opened, to my knowledge, in one of these, was worth 250 million ISK in a single can. Yeah, but then there's also the blueprints, which could get you lots of money. Definitely worth running these sites. Yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed this course. If you have enjoyed it, hit that like button. And here you can see the cans exploded. But I took no damage. They just kind of disappeared. We get a nice little fireworks show to end it off. So yeah, if you liked the video, hit that like button. If you got any questions, comments, concerns, etc., type them down below, and I will get to them pretty quickly. Other than that, we do stream on Twitch every day at approximately 1700 GMT. And so I will see you guys there. And of course, links in the descriptions. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy your day. Bye-bye.